Hello friends, in this video I'll be helping with the components of an image processing system. So here's the easy diagram of image processing system, which is the compulsory part. So here's the components. I will be explaining each in brief, so you can write it in your own words, but you have to draw this diagram as it in your exam. So let's start. So first is image displays. Image displays, as the name suggests, are the basic displays, whether it is a LED or whether it is any monitor or a computer screen, which is used to display the image, or you can say that it is the final step of an image processing system, because the ultimate motive of image processing is to display a particular image on the image displays. Second is hard copy devices. As the name suggests, hard copy is basically taking the hard copy of the image processed, like a CD-ROM or you can say a printer, where you take the hard copy of the image processed. Then comes the network you need to transmit image for the image processing purpose. Then comes the computer. It is used for performing general purpose tasks, whereas if we talk about the mass storage, if you are processing an image, you always need a mass storage device to store the image, as well as to process the image, you regularly need a mass storage device to save it regularly. Then comes the image processing software. This is needed when you want to process the image according to the user's choice, as well as a specialized image processing hardware, because only software will not do it. You also need a particular specialized hardware for the same purpose, and then you can use a software or you can embed a software on it. Then comes the image sensor, or you can say that this is the first step, basically the capturing the image, or you can say sensing the image. So this was all about in brief. So you can draw this diagram and write in brief, but if you want a detail point, I'll be explaining you in bit detail. So this is the image sensor. So it refers to basically sensing, or you can say capturing the image, or you can say it is the first step of the image processing system. It captures the incoming light, convert it into an electrical signal, measures that signal and output it to the supporting electronics. So what it does is, its primary function is to capture the image or capture the light which is coming to the electric device and convert it into a form of electrical signal, and basically forward it for the image processing. Is a 2D array of light sensitive element that convert photons to electrons. So basically it is light sensitive, then only it can capture the image part. And CCD and CMOS image sensors are widely used nowadays. It has two elements to capture digital image. First is physical device, like a camera. You can see their pixels are there, that is a physical device or sensor. And second is digitizer, that converts the analog picture into its digital form. So these two elements would do the image sensor work. Next is the specialized image processing hardware. It consists of a digitizer and a hardware that performs other primitive functions. So the primary functions, like how to store an image, capture an image, converting an image from analog to its digital form, or you can say converting an image into its binary form, is done with the help of specialized image processing hardware. Or you can say it has a software, but it has a specialized hardware also. It performs, its functions are primary functions, just like the ALU or arithmetic logical unit, which performs the arithmetic and logical operations in parallel on entire images. Then comes the computer. As I told you, computer is basically a general purpose computer, just a general tasks. It performs general tasks and can range from a PC for a simple user to a supercomputer for multiple users or for a large database users. Then comes the image processing software. It consists of the specialized module that perform the specific tasks. So image processing software is designed according to the user choice, like what processing or what is needed by the user, and according to that the modules are designed, and according to that the specific tasks are performed. Next comes the mass storage. So whenever you are doing image processing, you always need a mass storage device, because you obviously need to store an image somewhere. So mass storage is a necessary part, as well as mass storage should be easily accessible by the device, so that it can regularly store the image, then process, then store. So it should be easily accessible by the computer. Then comes the image displays. Image display, as I told you, it is basically the final motive or the final step of image process, or you can say it is the last goal of an image processing system, to display the image. So nowadays color TV monitors, computer display monitors and different monitors come. So these are the example of image display where you can see the digital image on the screen. Next comes the hardware hard copy device. As I told you, it is basically the laser printers, film cameras, heat sensitive devices or CD-ROM where you take the hard copy of the image process that was processed to digital form, and taking a hard copy into a CD or on a paper or on some other you can say physical equipments. Next comes the networking. Networking is needed basically to transmit image information for the image processing or image storing or some other purpose. So this was all about components of an image processing system. So if you like the video, do hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and feel free to share your precious feedback. So till then, bye bye.